Thank you, Heather. And it's always just a real pleasure for me to be at UBC. I am a Vancouver native, and my first two degrees, not my MLIS, but my BA and my MA are from UBC, so it's always just a huge pleasure to come back. I began my teaching career here at UBC, so it just sort of feels like coming home. It's quite lovely to be here. So I'm going to be talking today about an ongoing research project that I've been working on since 2009. There we go. And my agenda, what I plan to talk about, is just briefly setting some context about, you know, how do we define regional literature, and, you know, why it's important, you know, is it important, and why it's important, and why a resource such as CStacks is needed, you know, what the reasons are behind our development of that site. Then I'll talk a little bit about the actual CStacks project itself, and I hope that I have time, and I have about 45 minutes, right, Heather? So hopefully I'll have time at the end to talk a little bit about how CStacks can actually be used for research, and I'll talk a little bit about one of the investigations that I'm just in the early stages of beginning using CStacks. So the first question, and the question that really stimulated this whole project, is the question of, you know, why is it important for youth to read local books? And, you know, speaking as I said, I'm a Vancouver native, I don't think I read a book that was set even in BC until I was in university. You know, growing up as a child, I read a steady stream of British children's books. You know, some Canadian, but not Canadian set in the West. I mean, some Ontario, all the Anne of Green Gables books, but nothing that was local, you know, to my own experience of the world. I grew up, you know, wishing that I, you know, went to a British boarding school. I mean, I was desperate, you know, for that experience that I kept reading about in all my books. So, you know, that was one of the questions that kind of stimulated a lot of this project is, you know, is it important? And we're defining local as being books by local authors, illustrated by local illustrators, or published by local publishers, or set in a local setting. So we're taking quite a broad, inclusive definition of what local means. You know, why or why not is this important? And what is really the value of reading local? So we started doing some review of the literature, and what we found was really there wasn't a lot that had actually investigated the value to youth, in particular, of reading books that were set in their own environment or in a familiar region. Judy Saltman, whom you all know, has talked about, you know, the children's literature being a microcosm of a country's literary and sociocultural values. And by extension, you could assume that, you know, the same would go for a smaller region, you know, that when you're dealing with regional literature, you're dealing with the values and the issues that are particular to that locality. Several years ago, Pantaleo did a study that demonstrated that reading regional literature could actually improve students' self-image and their academic performance. But there really hasn't been very much investigating how much regional literature is actually used in Canadian schools. One of the catalysts to some of the studies that took place about a decade ago was the decline in teacher librarians in around 2001, 2002, when a lot of the severe reductions in teacher librarians were taking place. There were some studies in the use of more Canadian literature in Canadian schools as opposed to really the regional. Bainbridge, Carbonaro, and Green did a study based in Alberta that showed that most elementary school teachers were not that familiar with Canadian books. Baird and Wiley, the very next year, did a Canadian study that showed that high school students, for the most part in Canada, were reading non-Canadian literature and that school libraries had inadequate collections of Canadian materials. And their conclusion was that teachers and administrators really didn't have time to seek out those Canadian or, by extension, regional materials. And, you know, there really were not enough guides to the literature, especially the regional literature. Now, in Nova Scotia, which is my home turf, this situation is particularly acute. I mentioned in the informal discussion just a little while ago that the Teacher Librarian Association of Nova Scotia disbanded about 5 years ago when its membership dwindled down to four. There's very few teacher librarians left in the province. Many school libraries have such small budgets they can only afford about 8 books a year, so it's very, very tiny budgets. There's no provincial standards or benchmarks for how much funding school libraries receive, and it is well below the national average in Nova Scotia. And as a result, the selectors that are in school libraries, who are very often technicians, school library technicians, or graduates of the library technician program, they're wonderful people. They work really well with the kids, but they may not be as aware of local titles or how to, or the importance of bringing those local titles into the school. This particular year, there was a bit of a scandal. In the same week that the provincial government launched or introduced an I Love Local license plate, the public school book orders were delayed when there was a huge public outcry because the provincial government had decided to import all of its school books from a U.S. supplier. And this decision was ultimately reversed because there was so much public outcry, but it gives a bit of a sense that the attention to the local and the regional is really not, does not seem to be taking place in Nova Scotia. As a result, the same incident prompted the establishment of a Read Local Facebook page in Nova Scotia to invite discussion on the promotion of public school use of books created and published, particularly in Nova Scotia, but also in Canada, that parents and it seems particularly parents, but also bookstore owners and publishers are very concerned about the lack of local and regional books in Nova Scotia schools. So way back in 2009, it seems like a long time ago now, I did an online survey of all schools, elementary, junior high, and high school, in Atlantic Canada. So this was in Nova Scotia, New Brunswick, Prince Edward Island, and Newfoundland and Labrador. And I basically was asking three key questions in that survey. Did teachers think it was important to include regional books or to introduce children to regional books? Did they actually do it? And I asked them, in the past year, have you used any regional books in your classes? And do you feel well informed about regional books? Do you feel you have an adequate knowledge and can select regional books to use in your classes? So, I didn't really know what to expect, but the numbers were actually, fairly dramatic, in that almost all of the teachers said, theoretically, absolutely. I believe that I should be using regional books. I think it's really important to include regional books. Atlantic Canadian kids should know who their local authors are. Less than half had actually done so in the previous year, and I think that number is probably a bit inflated because the previous year was the centennial of Anne of Green Gables. And pretty much every grade 7 class in Prince Edward Island, absolutely, every grade 7 class was doing Anne of Green Gables. But in many of the other provinces as well, Anne of Green Gables was on the reading list. That may not be the case in a normal year when it's not sort of a festival of Anne. So I think that number, if anything, is probably a little high. Like if I did the survey again, it might not be that same number. But only about 19.6% felt that they were well informed. So it was quite a dramatic slide, that only 20% or just less than 20% felt that they really did know. And a number commented, I do know about Anne of Green Gables, but I don't really.